Hello, YouTubers. In this video, we're going to be covering my nephew's 2018 Honda Civic Sport Touring with the 1.5-liter turbo motor in it. The story begins a couple of years ago when he turned 15. My sister-in-law and brother-in-law purchased the car for my nephew, and this is all he ever wanted, all he could ever dream of. In fact, he ordered this car on CarMax from Charleston and had it delivered to the local CarMax dealer where he lives, all by himself at 15, and they delivered the car. Very ironic. So he really wanted this car. This is what he got, and he was happy to have it. But like all things, my nephew wanted more power. And so he came to me and asked me about a cold air intake. And I told him, I said, a cold air intake is no harm, no foul. Just means it's going to allow the car to breathe a bit better. So I don't see a problem with that. So he asks his dad, and his dad says same thing. And so the air intake goes into the car. Well, that's not good enough. Next thing he wanted was to have tuning software installed on the car to increase the power. So he came to me and asked me what my thoughts were about that, and I told him a big fat no. That car is a 1.5-liter engine, about as small an engine as you could possibly get in a car in America today. I don't even know if the smart car is around, and maybe its engine was bigger than this engine. I don't know, but 1.5 liters. I've had motorcycles with bigger engines between my legs. It's crazy how little the engine is. So I told him, no, don't do it. Because that motor, I'm sure, is already optimized to its maximum potential from Honda so that you can reliably remove you from A to B and as efficient as possible, because he can't afford gas. So he goes to his dad, asks his dad the same question, and his dad says, sure, you should do it. Nothing can go wrong. Well, 6 months later, my nephew is riding along like an angel, like he always does, he says, at 70 miles an hour in a 70-mile-an-hour speed limit zone. Not doing 71, he was doing 70, so he is an angel. And he said, all of a sudden, he felt the car shake, and the steering shuddered, and he pulls off the side of the interstate and takes a look under the car, and he sees oil all over the place. So he cuts the car off. Good for him. But then we get to looking deeper at the car, and we figure out, oh my Lord, this has grenaded. If you can imagine throwing a grenade inside of an engine, this is what this looks like, and here are the pictures and videos to show you this engine. What you're looking at is a catastrophe. And it all began with bad decisions. So that is the point of this video. I'm not going to cover fixing this car. I'm not going to cover what's going to take place to get it back on the road. That's not this video. This video is for people who are potentially looking at buying tuning software, such as KTuner, and putting it on a Honda Civic 1.5-liter engine. I don't even care if it's a Honda Accord, doesn't matter, CRV. These 1.5-liter engines cannot take extra power. So he installed this KTuner software on it, and they increased the boost from, I think it was 18 to 23, and this car just can't take that. If you can look at, as you see this engine, what you're seeing here is it's blown in half down cylinder number two. If the head was not still bolted onto the top of the engine, this would fall into two pieces. That's how bad this engine blew. But he said he was driving at 70 miles an hour like an angel. It's no way, not possible. That took place under pressure and under stress. The car was moving, I am positive. So, again, the point of the video, too, is to, like I said, is to make you aware of these things and bad decisions. Don't modify these cars. Like I had to tell my nephew, do you know how much that tuning software is going to cost you now? He's like, I've already paid for the tuning software. It was $500. I said, well, didn't you pay somebody $500 to install it and configure it? He said, yes. I said, didn't you do a cold air intake? Yes. So he's into the car for $1,300 before he blew it. I said, now, in order to buy another engine and install it and get it back up and running, you're going to probably, if you're lucky, get one for $3,000, put it back in the car. So now, your decision 6 months ago to install the KTuner software is now going to cost you $4,300, if you're lucky. If you're lucky, because it all goes back to that decision. So that's what this software is ultimately going to cost you. I would advise people, if you're looking at these things, doing these modifications on your engines, don't do it. Look at these pictures, look at this video. It should be alarming to you. It should be a red flag. Don't mess with the engine. Leave it alone. If you have to have a car with more power, don't let the Honda 1.5 liter turbo motor be your baseline. Buy another car. Buy something that can support extra power, extra boost, or extra whatever it is you want to do to the car. These cars are not designed for that, as you can clearly see from the catastrophe that's taken place. Anyway, YouTubers, if you like the video, like the video.